Hey, hey, and welcome to the Rada Explained series. This is a follow-up video to my last one. I feel I didn't go deep enough on how to cut, on the body mechanics of the cut, and how to utilize the force of the opponent. Just like within that video on how to step, some of this is interpretation. Rada himself does not go as deep on these topics. I failed to mention it in my last video. But of course all the cuts can be vertical too, not just diagonal, thanks to all the people who pointed it out. The full cuts, the circular ones, can be done in a variation that is vertical. It is usually then aimed at the head. Do remember that a cut is a slicing motion, not a chop. It needs a forward or backwards motion to be a slice. If it lacks that, it will be flat and a chop. And not slice. In modern practice, they use blunt swords, so you might find this less relevant. But there is another reason to do slices instead of chops. That is the safety of our practice partner. When we do a chop, we get the maximum amount of percussive force going straight into our opponent, our practice partner, which increases the risk of injury. A slicing motion aims the force more diagonally to the target. This means less force is transferred directly. With a sharp sword, this would cut into the target, but now it will just hit less hard. So it's both more martially sound and it's a safer. When doing all the cuts, you thus want to do a snap movement with the wrist in the end of the cut, right before it hits. You do this by pulling the fingers together as you move forward or backwards. Which direction depends on the direction of the rest of the movement. You want to align it with the rest of the movement. Usually, you will attack by moving forward, but there are occasions when you move backwards instead. When a cut has a vertical component, it is fairly simple to do the cut. You mostly have to let the gravity do its job. The simplest cut is a diagonal medial cut. You lift the sword and then let it fall down. Towards the end of the cut, you can add a bit of extra force yourself from the wrist, but it's mostly gravity cutting for you. For the circular cuts, you don't want to add extra force yourself until you have the blade aligned, which is about halfway through the cut. When the opponent gives you a heavy push in any direction, the trick is to find the closest cut and steer the blade into the path of that, without directly opposing the force. Relax and don't fight the blade. Let the forces affecting the blade be there. Steer them to your advantage. Often the easiest cut to do this with is the full reverse or full tajo. By moving the blade in a circle, you take the force and steer it back where it came from. The more force, the heavier the cut. It is mostly applicable to downward forces or horizontal force. If you get pushed upwards, you can use it to cut a half cut, but it doesn't conserve momentum. For horizontal cuts, there is no gravity to help you, so you need to power them completely with your body mechanics. The full cuts are usually not done horizontally. Of course, they are theoretically possible, but not something ordained by Rada at all. For the half cuts, they are very commonly done horizontally from attacco 2 and 3, when you do not have your point in line. I will talk about the 8 attacco at a later point. But for now, I will start from attacco 2 and 3 to show the body mechanics of the horizontal cuts. You need to power the cuts with your feet and hips. The rotation at the hips will travel up the chain and rotate your shoulders. Your shoulders will move your arm, which will affect the sword. So a rotation in the hip will move the sword. The step you will do will be very similar to the standard Rada's attacking step series. When doing it from attacco 2, you step away from the center to the left for a right-handed fencer, and from attacco 3 you will step away from the center to the right instead. This is one of the few times I think you should step so you're not facing the opponent straight, but instead out and away. This is to create a hip rotation to power the cut. The second component of the cut is the arm. You can move it slightly in the direction of the cut as you lift it up, but not overly much. Just a little bit is enough as everything adds together. Lastly, you will extend the blade at the wrist to add another motion in the same direction. Combination of step, hip, arm and wrist will add up to a very powerful cut. The amount of raw force in this, if done right, is extreme, so be careful with it. It's important that you sync this motion together, or it will not work. After the cut is complete, you want to move your back foot forward and then retreat back, turning the front foot towards the opponent again as you move to the right angle again. I hope this was helpful, going through the details of the cuts. Remember, the cuts shouldn't be forced. They should come when the opportunity arises. In my next video, I will take a look at Rada's exercises for the cuts.